I'd like to see you too.
If you have any questions, you write them down or remember them. So after we have the hypnosis session, and after you wake up refreshed, which is your sixth sense, your inner voice, and the feeling of deja vu which you get. It all comes from your subconscious. In fact, we all go to the subconscious many times in the day, even though we do not know. Daydreaming is a subconscious activity. Dreaming in the night is a subconscious activity. Driving to the same place is what we call highway hypnosis. So even though you get into your car, you reach your workplace, but you don't know how you have reached. The thoughts are somewhere else. Handwriting is a subconscious activity. Handwriting analysis will actually tell a lot about the person, what his current frame of mind is. So whenever we do a session, one-to-one, we first ask them to fill up a form. The main reason for that form is we know the person what he is troubled with, whether he's an introvert, extrovert, whether he will share, he will not share. So accessing the subconscious by being aware of it is what is hypnosis. In this, I do not do anything. All hypnosis is actually self-hypnosis. And the language of hypnosis is imagination. Imagination arises from thoughts which actually arise from the mind. So even though you start off with a conscious imagination, eventually it is the subconscious which will take you there. Wherever you start with, eventually you will go to the issue which is troubling. First, I'll tell you about an example of how we start off with hypnosis. The example which I give to most of the people is, if you close your eyes and I ask you to imagine a flower, you will all imagine a flower. Then if I ask you what flower, just close your eyes, three of you close your eyes, you imagine a flower. Okay, open your eyes. Which flower did you imagine?
Since you mentioned it, yellow rose.
Tulip.
Yellow rose.
Which color tulip?
Yellow. Orange rose.
It is a flower, but all three have stuck with them. So that is the first step. Then if I ask them, where is the flower, they go to a location. That location will vary. So the mind will, I keep guiding and asking questions and you keep going down deeper. The moment you go down deeper into your imagination, you are actually cut off from the conscious mind. You are not aware of what is going on here because you are somewhere else. The moment you are somewhere else is the subconscious. and a hypnosis from where, that somewhere else, will take you to the cause of your issue or problem. How is it similar to meditation? So when we talk about meditation, what exactly is meditation? Meditation is nothing but being with yourself, with your inner you. So you try to make your mind blank, still your thoughts. But do you know what the mind is like? It has been said that the mind is like a drunken monkey which has been bitten by 1,000 bees. It's jumping around like that. A new thought comes in every 3 seconds. Stilling the mind is more difficult than stopping the wind. And meditation is the art of stilling the mind and making it blank. Very simple to say in one line, mind ko still kar lo, stop all your thoughts. But people who have tried meditation realize that it is so difficult. The reason it is difficult is, it is like a ladder. As you go up the ladder, you have to lift your foot from the lower rung to put it on the upper rung. Means you have to leave something to go and achieve something. We are not willing to leave anything. So you never go up. Until you leave the things you are attached with, you are bound with, how will you go up? You can't carry up anything. When you are willing to leave everything, then the door will open. Otherwise the door will not open. And if you don't leave, you are caught in the circus and you will have to dance around in the circus. So to start off with meditation is the same as what you start off with hypnosis. You at least go away from the conscious mind. So what people say in meditation, you sit quietly, some say concentrate on a mantra, Om. Some say concentrate on an inner eye, forehead. Some say you concentrate on whichever God you believe in. Most say you concentrate on your breath. Watch your breath. This all is in one line. It summarizes from many to one, from one to none. From many thoughts, you have to focus on one thought. From one thought, you go to no thought. But initially, when you start focusing, you will be only able to focus on one thought for maybe 5 seconds, 10 seconds, 15 seconds. But with practice, it keeps increasing. And it will keep increasing till you start removing all the clutter in your life. Puja sab karte hain, bahut log karte hain. But actually, if you look at yourself, puja kya karte ho? Mandir mein ghanti baja di. Soch kya rahe ho? Dudh upar hai, kitchen mein, wo ubal to nahi jayega. Udhar khana banana hai, udhar jana hai. Mantra phadapat, 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 it keeps saying. What is the use of that? Who are you trying to bribe or fool? If you have to say a prayer, say thank you first. Rest, if you have to do, God is not in a mandir. God is not anywhere. He is everywhere and including within you. So to meditate, as it has been described by our oldest book, which is Patanjali's Yoga Sutras, the entire treatise of how to meditate and yoga and all that is written. So yoga is another new fad which is there now that everybody wants to do yoga. Like Baba Ramdev. But that is not yoga. That is basically exercises to make your body fit. And how do you make your body fit? And why do you want to need to make your body fit? The reason is if you have to still your mind, you have to have a body which is within your command. If you can sit for half an hour, 1 hour, without your body drumming you, only then can your mind be still. So yoga is the first step. So if you look at the eighth path of Patanjali, which he says, the yam and the niyam. Yam is what you are all supposed to know. Be good, be kind, be honest, don't do this, don't do that. Niyam is society, what you are supposed to do, how to live in society. These are two basic tenets which everybody knows. The third part is the one which is the yogic exercises. The asanas, the mudras, they help you to make your body supple so that you can go to the next level.